Hey guys, it's I can't even do it. I'm too sad. I can't do it. Hi, I'm Rin. And the Klexicon is over and I'm so sad. I am so sad to be home. I've never been this sad before to come home from a holiday. It feels like I left home and now I'm just here without everyone and I just miss everyone so much. I'm not too sure how long this video is going to be because I might have a lot of feelings. I wrote some notes, guys, just in case I didn't want to forget anything that happened over the course of that few days of bliss. It was such a good convention, guys. Just first, right off the bat, I need to get that off my chest. It was such a good convention, more than I could have imagined it to be. I think it was such a successful convention as well, let alone for being a first-time con. I think it exceeded everyone's expectations, and I remember just being in that space and everyone having a smile on their face and talking and being happy with each other, and it was really unlike anything else I've ever experienced. So I am so thankful to the organizers and the volunteers and everyone who made Klexicon happen. You guys have given all of us who attended a gift. You really did, and I think we're all gonna treasure it forever, and we're really just looking forward to the next one. I am so eager for you guys to announce the next one. Please do it soon because it'll mean I have something to look forward to. So my Vegas trip actually started on the 1st of March is when I flew in, and we had organized beforehand to meet up at the airport because we were all staying at Bally's together. So I met up with Rachel, Sophia, Elka and Liv, and it was such a strange feeling because I don't know, it's weird because I've seen Sophia and Elka's face so much on YouTube and watching all of their videos, so it felt like I'd known them for ages, and that it wasn't like meeting someone new. It wasn't that feeling. It was like meeting someone I don't know, it was like meeting a lost friend or something like that, because you recognize them so vividly, but I don't know, it was weird, but it was great because that feeling didn't last for very long. Like, the weirdness went away and it felt like we'd been friends for ages, and it was really nice. So it was great to meet them straight away when I got into Vegas. So our first day in Vegas only started in the late afternoon is when we all finally got in. So we didn't really do much. We went to In-N-Out, which is good. I did go drinking with Sophia, and we did get a little bit drunk with some other friends of mine. And I don't know, apparently it's inappropriate to want to call for towels at 2 a.m. and have a shower at 3 a.m. But whatever. Needless to say, I was hungover as fuck for Thursday. I was feeling so bad. Oh my god. We went to get waffles. I didn't get anything because I was feeling terrible. But we went to get waffles. And there's this like display fake waffle that they leave on the counter. And Sophia picked it up thinking it was hers. And like stood with it for ages. And she even asked the girl for extra cutlery. And they never said anything that she took the display waffle. So I don't know. It was hilarious. And I think Elka discovered that it was fake because she tried to eat the strawberry. And yeah, and then we pretty much chilled in our room for a while. We spent a lot of time just chilling in our room. But Thursday was the badge party pickup night, which was really exciting. I was looking forward to that. It was at the Phoenix, so you had to either catch an Uber or get a taxi or whatever. No, we were told by the guys while we were waiting for a taxi, instead of catching, we needed like 3 taxis. They suggested we catch the party bus. We're like, okay. Okay, so we caught over the party bus and it stunk like shit in there. There was a pole in the middle. It was not pleasant. So when we entered the bar, the Phoenix, they had like a photo wall on the right and they were taking photos of some other guys first. And we walked in and it was like flash, 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 flash. That is all I remember. And people moving us to the side. And Elka just going, Liv, hold my bag! And yeah, like a lot of people just started taking photos of us and we didn't have time to try to comprehend what was going on. So we're just like, okay. So that was like a really surreal entrance into the whole Klexicon experience. Yeah, we just like met a lot of people. It was so good and it was so relaxed and welcoming. And it was so cool to put faces to names on Twitter that you see all the time, or to like comments and stuff. It was the coolest thing, and I'm so glad they had the badge party as an introduction to Clexicon, because it really set the tone for the rest of the con for me. And highlights of the badge party was definitely winning pool, winning Mario Kart, and also getting to meet the organizers who we had been speaking to for months, you know. So we met Holly, love you Holly, Ashley, who was dealing with us a lot, and also Danielle, but I'd met her before when she came to Sydney. So it was so great to meet those guys. I met Nicole, they are the organizer, on the third con day, I think, maybe. Day one of Clexicon, we had arranged to have breakfast with our other YouTube panelists, Adrienne and Meg, and also her wife, Rachel. So we went to one of the restaurants in Bally's, and they had a buffet breakfast, which looked really good, but I was too nervous to eat. I was feeling so sick and so nauseous because I was going to be on the Lexus Legacy panel later that day, and I couldn't eat anything. I picked at their fruit. I stole pieces of fruit off their plates. And I just had some water and couldn't really do anything. I was a mess. And so after we had breakfast, we decided to just go to the con and pick up our passes and stuff.
You guys ready?
Nope. I'm not ready.
Okay, we're gonna walk in to the floor.
I kind of have to pee as well.
I have to go to the bathroom. But we're like filming ourselves.
Yeah. So why are we all so close together?
Because you have to get in the shot.
Oh shit.
Fuck. So as we were walking towards the con, you could hear people, like a big crowd coming, and the closer you get, the more people you saw. And there was already like a big line. I think there was probably like 200 to 300 people there already. And it was pretty early. It was before the con doors were opening. And they were all lining up and everyone was just really excited, I think. So we picked up our badges, our VIP badges, which, guys, this is probably my most prized possession that I brought back from Clexicon. Even more so than the signatures and the books and the photo. I don't know. This represents the con to me somehow. I just love it. And I just got my shoot badges on it. It's got my short arrow, my gay cat, and the iron, root iron. And now it's signed by Sophia Nelka. Oh, I miss you guys. So I love this badge. And we also got the swag bag. Sweet bag. Which is pretty cool because they gave you like a shot glass, a Clexicon shot glass, a stubby holder, and there's like a Planned Parenthood badge, which I'm wearing here because I got a couple, a Clexicon chip, which has the dates on the back. Oh, I miss you guys. Like a program, a sticker, there's like a comic book in here, a magazine, a couple of magazines, and oh, lip balm, Vegas lip balm. Oh my god, this is really nice. I'm just gonna put this on. I miss it. That's better. I feel more at home now. And it was time for me to go in, so Sophie and Elka went to line up. And when I went in, it was pretty much empty everywhere. So it was so cool to actually get to see the con floor before everyone, and people were setting up their tables and all of that. So they took me to the main hall, which is where Lex's Legacy was gonna be in, and it was overwhelming to say the least. There was so many chairs, it was such a big room, and then there's just the stage at the front with the Clexicon backdrop, and then like chairs. Guys, that did not help me feel any better. But inside was already a couple of the panelists, and also Tara, who's actually my friend from Sydney, who I met at LizaCon last year. So comforting to see her, and she's the one who asked me to be on the panel in the first place. So it was kind of great to catch up with her before the panel actually started. I was still very nervous, but a bit less so, and until the panel started, what did we do? We went to go get beers. Went to go get beers because, guys, it's like my security blanket. So I got the beers with Tara, and then they were testing a lot of stuff in the hall, so we're just waiting around for a while before that. And then they started to let people in. And there was like a line area within the room. So you could see people gathering there, and I took a couple photos of that, and you can actually see like Sophie and Elka waving at me. It's really cute. So I went back behind the backdrop behind the big screen, and just waited there for until everyone came in, and I took a couple shots of that too. And it looked pretty much like the whole room was getting filled out, which was nuts. It was so cool to see. And yeah, just, I can't remember that much from the panel. It was very nerve-wracking, but at the same time, I think I got through it, hopefully. I think my voice cracked a few times because that's what happens when I'm nervous. But I really, like, loved the video that Tara made. She's the girl from LGBT Fans Deserve Better. Yeah, I didn't see it before that day, so it was quite a shock to see my face on that massive screen, but even more so to actually hear people cheering for me was the most absurd thing. And I think that's what made me cry, is because I never expected that, you know. I didn't expect people to give me that sort of reception, so it was like the kindest thing, and I was feeling very overwhelmed by everything, so I did shed quite a few tears. Luckily it was dark and I managed to sort of get myself a bit under control when they finally turned on the lights. So on that panel, as well as Tara, it was moderated by Jess at LGBT Fans, and I also had Paper Cat, Linnea, which is so great to meet her, and Vidheader, April, and Lexa, the documentary filmmaker. So it was a pleasure to share that panel with you girls on the first day, the first opening panel. It was like, I will never forget it for the rest of my life. So thank you guys for making it awesome. This video is gonna be so long, but I'm sorry, I just need to get it all out. So after that, I did go to the ethics and storytelling panel. I think the other girls went to something else, like one of the reunions. It might have been the specialty one. But I never watched South of Nowhere, so I didn't feel like I needed to go to that. So instead, I wanted to definitely check out the ethics and storytelling panel because my friend Heather was on it. And there was only two other people who didn't want to go to the special reunion, and it was Maddie, Creative Habit on Tumblr, and Erin, Headers Warrior on Tumblr. And so we headed to that, and I am so glad we went to that because it was such a good panel. It had Heather, as I said, Gretchen Ellis, and Elizabeth Bridges, and they were really insightful, smart women talking about ethics and storytelling, and it was such a great panel. I'm so happy I went. Also quickly, I did run into Jessica Nicole by the lifts, so I did ask her for a photo, and I didn't really get to say much, but I just was like, I love you and Fringe. And then we went to the Klexa meetup. We got there a little bit late, so it was kind of awkward when we went in because I didn't realize it was going to be a whole bunch of tables and everyone would be sitting down. So by the time we got there, all the tables were already full, so there was anywhere we could really sit or do anything, so we stood awkwardly in the corner and just like talked amongst ourselves for a bit. We did manage to take a photo with the cosplay Clark and Lexa, the couple. We were adorable, and as soon as we took a photo with them, people started like lining up to take more photos with them. So I think everyone was just really eager to get a photo with Clark and Lexa, which they should have because it was such a great cosplay. So the meetup was cool, but we didn't really get to stay around too much, so we headed to the year in review panel, which is another LGBT fans one, and it was really good, but unfortunately our YouTube panel overlapped, so we had to leave pretty early and go do our YouTube panel. And Sophie and Elka guys, they were nervous. They were super nervous. I tried to calm them down and say it wasn't going to be an issue and that people were just there to because they love them and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, they were sort of pissing themselves. So we went to the panel, set up our stuff, hooked up the computer because we had organized an intro video by VidHeader. Thank you so much, April.
Oh no.
Down the bottom.
Thank you to everyone who showed up for our panel. It really meant so much to us. We were scared that not that many people would come, like 10 people would come. So it was cool to see the room almost full. I want to say there was probably about 80 people there, if not more. So it was such a pleasure to get the chance to talk to everyone and answer your questions and just tell a bit of our stories and our journey over the past year. I'm glad we got to meet a few of you afterwards as well and just like take photos and do all that stuff. Oh, and I was given this shirt. I think I forgot to talk about it. I think because this was after the first panel, but I got given this shirt. It says Four Alarm Fire and it's got like Amy and Sarah in it. Well, Root and Shaw in it. And the girl gave it to me because she said Four Alarm Fire so I would never forget again. And I think, sorry, if you're on Instagram, NikeGirl510. Thank you so much. I really love it. And as you can see, it fits. Yeah, so that was pretty much day one. It was crazy and it was so cool just to walk around the floor and get to talk to so many people and meet people that I've wanted to meet before. So day two of Clexicon was shoot day for me. That's all I had committed to, Amy and Sarah, all day. So I went for the team up photo first thing in the morning and I was so nervous. And no one else in my group had really bought that team up photo. So it was just me in the line. But luckily I could just be crying in the line loudly and people would talk to me. So that was nice and comforting. And I don't really remember too much about going in and taking the photo because it's so quick, as anyone who took a photo knows. But I did say, like, to Amy that I'm still sad about Fred, and I said to Sarah that I'm sure is my favourite character. So I managed to say that, and they were beautiful, and when we were taking the photo I feel like they were this close to me, like their hair was this close to me, and it was a great... Oh, where's my photo? So it was a great experience, I'm really happy I did it. And this is the photo. I mean, I'll put a pop of Figma on it. And yeah, Sarah was wearing heels. Big heels, guys. That's why, okay? Otherwise, I feel like she's... Wait, why am I... I feel like she's only this much taller than me. So that wasn't fair. But she had her equality t-shirt. It was great. And it was cool just hearing, like, all the screams in the hall because you knew... It was them, like, just walking through or going to the bathroom or something. Which Elka ran into Sarah Shahi in the bathroom, which is rude.
Oh my god, Father.
So after I got my photo taken, we tried to calm down for a little bit. And then Elka and Sophia and I, we had our table talk lunch, which was organized by the con as a way to sort of... give people a chance to have a one-on-one chat over lunch with for an hour. So we did that and I was so scared that no one would show up for my table. Enough, I had a bunch of people, Steph, Eddie, Tammy, Brie and Naomi. Thank you so much for showing up. It really means so much to me and I really valued our time together. I'm so happy we got to chat and just, it was actually a really nice break from the con just to get to sit down, have a few bites of my meal because I couldn't eat. But it was, yeah, it was a really nice break. Our table was better than Heather Hogan's table. I still stand by that. But yeah, I'm so happy we got the time to do that and very thankful that you guys came. And the shoot panel, the reunion panel, was definitely something I'd been looking forward to for a while because it is so rare to get both of them at a con and both of them speaking about person of interest. So I was really genuinely intrigued to see what they would talk about and I think it went well for the most part. Just some of those first questions were a bit inappropriate to ask them in that sort of ever. So I was really lucky enough to get the chance to ask them a question. I'm actually going to put Sophia's video on my question because I didn't get any video.
Hi guys. I just want to know, besides your own characters on the show, who was your favourite character and why was it Bear?
Why was it Bear? That, assuming that we said Bear was our favourite.
I mean, that is the correct answer.
So the whole thing you could watch on the Periscope, actually, I'll put the link into that as well the time of when I asked my question. Their answer was long, so I don't want to put the whole thing in because this video is going to be long enough. But Sarah and Amy, when I was asking the question, they would look directly at me as they were talking. So I was staring into their eyes the whole time they were answering the question. So it was pretty great for me. So after the panel, it was straight to signings. And I will show you what I got signed. I got the second fan art book from LGBT fans, which you guys should definitely get. It's such a great book. There's like, it's a multi-fandom book, so a lot of different ships are in there. And I got signed an artwork by Maddie. This is what I got signed. Oh, something just fell out. So you can see that's Sarah's. She says, love you, love, 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 heart, heart, heart. And she says, kiss, kiss to you too, from Amy. And I also got Maddie to sign it. So they are sharing a page. There wasn't really much to say when I got self-signed by them. I just told them, I asked the question about Bear at the panel, and sorry for confusing Sarah, and she was like, it's okay. And I also told her that Shaw was my favorite character. And with Amy, I asked the question about Bear as well. And Amy, when she talks to you, she doesn't keep her head down and sign. She like looks at you. And she was like smiling and laughing to herself and was wondering why Sarah was so confused about that question. It was very sweet. And Amy just smiles and it's like sunshine is coming out of her face. So you cannot look away. It was lovely to meet them both. So after the signing, I sort of wanted to walk the con floor again. But as I was walking, Paperheader, her store, she stopped me and asked me if I wanted to get a original drawing from Little Lexa, which, guys, of course I want an original drawing from Little Lexa. It was only $1, which I think was a complete bargain, and I got this, and I also got to design it. So as she explained it to me, it's a big cat, the mum, and then a dad with a baby strapped on his back. Bella, you little Picasso. So that was really cute, and can I just add in, Little Lexa was the absolute star of the con. She was the biggest star of the con by far, absolutely. Everyone loved her. So then the last thing on that day was the Lost Girl reunion, which was so funny. Zoe and Rachel are amazing. Then it came to Sinful. Sinful was that night. Originally I had planned to go, but Sophia forced Elka and I to go. So we bought tickets and dressed up in black and white, and it was actually really fun. I'm glad I went. I'm really glad I went. We got drunk. We got drunk, guys, and it was fun, and I had a great time, except for, obviously, I've been shouting about this for the past few days. I lost my jacket. I don't know what happened. I know what happened. I was drunk and I put it on my bag, like wrapped around my little side bag, and it's a big long cardigan, so of course it's not going to stay there, especially when you go dancing. So it's gone, and I don't know what happened, and I spent the rest of the night looking for it and just shouting, and I was running around the venue multiple times checking every piece of clothing that I could find, but of course it's a black and white party, all the jackets were black, so I don't know what happened with it. You know, it's gone, it's okay. It's okay. You go and play Steel Dawn. Sinful was fun. Liv stole a chair and I didn't get a hangover. It was great. Well, wait. Before we move on to day 3, we did do a drunk Periscope, which I will link you to because it is hilarious and stupid. Sophia did it on her Periscope, so go check that out. That's fun. Day 3, it was the Holstein reunion. That's the only thing we really had planned, and the final panel, of course. But it was a bit more relaxed on day 3. There wasn't too much going on. Holstein were great. I think the reenacting of the scenes was probably a definite highlight, especially the Clark and Lexa ones, because that still gave me feels. And then it pretty much came time to the last panel, which was the LGBTQ actresses in TV and film. And I have to say, Jessica and Ali killed it. They were so great and so adorable and smart. and just really interesting, clever people. It was great to hear Ali's story, especially because I stupidly assumed she was out from the get-go on Bomb Girls, because I love her in Bomb Girls. Bomb Girls is one of my favourite shows. I was part of the Kickstarter when they tried to get Bomb Girls renewed when it got cancelled. So it was really such a great experience to get to see and hear her story and how Betty helped her find herself. And yeah, Jessica's just a badass. I mean, she knows what's up and she's really smart, so I'm definitely going to keep a close eye on her in the future as well. We got to meet Mo Ryan though, which was amazing. I was so happy we got the chance to thank her for everything that she did for fandom. She got us noticed in mainstream media, and that is no small feat, and I really think she's a big part of what projected the fandom to keep going. So we got to chat with her, it was great. My friend Lisa and also Sophia got interviewed by her, and they actually made it in her article about Klexicon, which I think is amazing and so cool. And yeah, and then it was pretty much sadness. I cried when the last panel was over because I knew that was it. So I shed a few tears then, and it was sad, guys. It was sad for the rest of the day. We went looking for dinner and had a sad dinner in the food court. And then just pretty much hung out in our room being sad. With PJ, Erin, myself, Sophia, Elka, Liv, and Lisa. I miss everyone. So yeah, it was sad. And on the final day, Sophia and Elka and I did a Periscope saying goodbye. And I'll link you to that as well. That one's not as fun. It's very sad. Then that was pretty much it. I mean, I still had one more day in Vegas, but Sophia didn't, so she left before 11, and that was very sad. So I hung out with Elka and Liv for the rest of the day, and we just like walked the strip again. We decided to go on the high roller because we were in Vegas and it was something to do, which was, it was actually pretty cool. We ate our lunch in there and we were the only ones in the thing, so that was good. Yeah, and then we went to the con floor one last time to have a look, to see if anything was there still, and it was all gone and it was all closed, and I had a sad cry on the floor, and that was pretty much it. And we collected our luggage and I left for the airport, and yeah, that was Klexicon. So being home, I'm just really sad being home. I'm really sad that it's over, and I will not cry, but it was really one of the greatest times of my life, to be honest. Like, there's no other way to put it. And oh my god, wow. It was just so nice to be able to be there and participate, and also meet everyone. What the fuck? Yeah, I didn't go to Klexicon with any expectations, and it exceeded by far so many of them. And the best part was definitely meeting everyone, and especially of course meeting Sophia and Elka, because we had gone on this journey together, so it felt like it was ours in a sense. So it was great to meet you guys. I miss you a lot, and I cannot wait for second Klexicon in next year. Yeah, just really thank you. I've met a whole bunch of people, lifelong friends for sure. And also just, I have to end again thanking Klexicon for creating this event. I know how hard you guys worked, because we were pestering you quite a bit throughout it, but it really meant so much to me, and I know it meant so much to everyone who attended, that you created this space for us. And yeah, I'm just like, this is happy. Oh my god, actual crying, actual tears. Stay in my eyes, tears. Stay in my eyes. Yeah, so I can't thank you guys enough. But that was it. That was Klexicon, and I will never forget it. And I will always be thankful that I got to go in the capacity that I got to go in. And I would also love to hear your guys's experience of Klexicon. I've already read quite a few like posts and stuff about it, and I love that it's all very positive and everyone feels like their life was changed a little bit, and I think that's really special. I know that once I get over the sadness of not being there, I can sort of feed off that energy. I'm so inspired by everything I saw at Klexicon, so there are some things I do want to revisit, that like just some ideas I had last year. So just thank you, know that you inspired me, Klexicon, and I know that so many hundreds, if not thousands, because I know about 2,200 attendees at least attended. So yeah, I can't thank you guys enough. Until Klexicon 2018, guys.